Oh, she is good. Here it comes. Let it all flood out, just gently.
Mark.
Me? Oh, I'm feeling pretty positive. Obviously, some tiny doubts.
Don't overdo it.
Mainly about the catering.
Well, that seems perfectly normal. Sophie, how about you?
Well, I just wish I felt that comfortable.
Hold on. Is that it? Is that my go finished? Did she just believe what I said? What kind of counselling is that? She didn't wheedle anything out of me. How am I supposed to blow my emotional beans if she doesn't at least give me a wheedle?
Plus, obviously, Sophie mentioned on the phone about the sexual problems in your relationship.
I'm sorry?
The sexual problems in your relationship.
Oh, right. Are there...
I just feel, I don't know, unfulfilled.
Unfilled?
Unfulfilled.
I suppose I thought that maybe Sophie might be one of those women who find it difficult or even impossible to attain, to achieve.
No, I'm definitely not one of those.
Right.
What would you say if you felt that you weren't going to be judged?
I'd say...
This isn't going to be good.
Often, Mark, you ejaculate quite a long time before I've had time to feel like I've started to enjoy our sex.
Uh-huh. Thanks for that, Soph. Great. Well, I'll make a note of that. Well, this has been great. Just a great time.
Mark, it's all right. We've got 45 minutes yet.
Really? 45 minutes?
Oh, great. So I'll be spending £1 a minute to hear how shit I am at sex. Now that's value for money.
Hey, Mark, I'll tell you what. You piss in this bottle, I'll drink it.
What? What the hell for?
For a laugh, it's the stag.
No, Jess, if you drank my piss, I'd feel violated.
Oh, that is great. You wouldn't even let me drink your piss. I'm not trying to kiss you, Mark. It's liquid waste.
I'm sorry, but no.
You wouldn't let me drink your piss.
Why would you even want to drink my piss?
For a laugh.
What the hell made you think of that?
I'm just bored, okay? I'd let you drink my piss.
Well, thank you very much.
Oh, come on, let's get out of here. Stewing our nuts in. Let's go and get you some sweet punani action.
I don't want sweet punani action. I want to take your bishop and grind you down.
Here, look, take it. And the horsey. Come on, man. Couple of pints, couple of hotties. Yeah? Come on, tiger. Let's roar.
Oh, God. I wish I lived with the chess computer. The chess computer wouldn't make me do things.
I'm stagging you. I'm stagging you by the back door. This is your stag.
Can I get a meter of vodka with an inch of tonic?
Come on, Mark. Turn it on. Play the game.
Oh, naughty. You've combined metric and imperial. You might get an interdenominational, from mixing the two measurement systems, a hangover of that kind.
Just stay mute, Mark. You're a social freak. Remain in your compound.
Morning, shipmate.
Jeremy, what the hell is going on?
Oh, just getting going. Couldn't let them get away, could we?
Ah, this is a new one. Water stalking.
It's not. It's just friendly. Ahoy there, shipmates.
Jeremy! Last one to lunch at the Lamb and Bag in Gassington is a loser.
You're on. Warp factor 3, please, Scotty.
Oh, great. I'm Scotty. He's off crossbreeding with the beautiful aliens, and I'm stuck down in the engine room with the probably cancer-emitting fuel cells.
So I'm not in a relationship right now. I've just been hurt too many times, you know?
Really?
Yeah, it's like I've got a river of pain running through me from here right the way down to here. Kind of like Jim Morrison or Russell Brand.
Dad, Jez has offered to do the shopping run and no one else is fit to drive.
Then you're going to handle a 4x4?
Sure, no sweat. 4x4. Piece of piss, probably. God, look at me drive. I'm Clarkson.
Are you sure it's okay to put in unleaded? We always normally do diesel.
Oh, trust me, these babies run on anything.
So, after we dump the shopping, do you want to go for a little stroll?
Just the two of us?
Yeah.
Cool.
Well, do you want to turn this around and I'll see you in a sec?
Oh, God, I think I love her. I think I'm falling in love. Or getting a bone on. Which is basically the same thing when you get rid of all the Valentine's cards and bullshit.
Come on, Mummy.
Oh, yeah. Pissed and stoned in a gas guzzler. This is the life. Already given a quid to Greenpeace this year, so I'm golden. Not the dog. Not the dog. Shit, the dog! Oh, yeah, this is cool. Just don't think about the dead dog. If I don't think about it, there's always a chance it didn't happen.
Let's roll, cowboy. Where's Mummy?
Mummy?
Yeah, I let her out for a piss.
Are you sure she was with us?
Jeremy, she was on the back seat.
She must have run off. Except she definitely hasn't, because I'm carrying her around in this bag.
She never just runs off.
She is a wild animal, you know, the call of the wild. She might have become leader of a pack of foxes or...
Jez, it's Mummy. We're not just leaving her.
Why did I put her in the bag? I should have thrown her like a discus.
Mummy! Come on, Jeremy.
Mummy!
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 Oh, God. I don't know what I'd do if I lost her. Mummy!
Well, you're very close to finding out.
Mummy!
Mummy!
We'll need a servant. These leftovers are from 2 nights ago, and he never empties the bin. Oh, God, I bet it's bursting at the seams with used condoms and porn.
Fuck! Ah! There's a dead beast in our bin, Jeremy!
All right, keep your voice down.
A dead dog in our bin! How has this happened?
I don't know, Mark, but there's no point shouting about it.
Well, why not? Jeremy, is this Mummy?
Look, earlier, in the 4x4, I had an accident. I mean, the clutch on that thing.
Oh, right. Brilliant. You've killed Mummy. Well, what the hell is it doing in our bin?
I had to hide it. Aurora had me looking for it for about 4 hours, and she made me make posters.
But the bin, Jeremy, the bin's for household waste, not beloved pets, etc.
Mark, if I can just get rid of the dog corpse, there's a chance I still might get laid here.
Oh, right. This is sort of like a disgusting version of the Great Egg Race.
This doesn't feel great.
It's not great, Jez, that's why.
There's no chance of it being traced back to us now, though, because it might have been microchipped.
Exactly. No, all things considered, my career prospects, your sexual desperation, this is probably the best thing to do.
There's a hell of a lot of steam.
Yeah, as it turns out, dogs do seem to be mostly water.
Well, it's going a bit, just not the legs.
Put the legs back on in the middle, maybe it'll burn better.
Oh, right. I have to put the legs back on. If you hadn't refused to pay for firelighters, it would have gone by now.
You shouldn't need firelighters to burn a dog, Jeremy.
How would you know? Shit, it's going out.
Look, I've got to get my pitch sorted before I see Malcolm.
We'll have to bury it. Get the spade.
What spade?
You didn't bring a spade?
Do you think I'm some kind of freelance dog-murdering mafia man?
Oh, great. So we've got no fire, no spade. We'll just have to dig with our hands.
Jeremy, there are many things I would do to help you. But digging a hole in the wintry earth with my bare hands so that you can bury the corpse of a dog you killed is not one of them.
I'll just take it to one of those massive council bins. Dump and run. Just like my paperboy days. Screw you, Murdoch.
Jeremy.
Hi.
This is my last poster. How did you get on?
Yep, good. Got rid of all of mine too. Just keep lying till the kissing can start. I mean, it'd have to be a fucking good poster to get that dog back.
I might call it a day and head back to the barge. Coming?
Okay. Shit. Gotta dump the evidence.
Jeremy, you've dropped your bag.
Yeah, so I have. Thanks, honey. Just act normal. I'll tell her what happened immediately after I've come.
What's in the bag?
Oh, Mark and I had a barbecue.
Oh, barbecue. Yum. Have you got any left?
No, not really. No, we were really hungry.
You have got a bit left, I can see.
It was really, really badly cooked. We didn't cook it at all well. Mark couldn't be bothered to get firelighters.
Well, just keeping a handle on the purse strings there. The ABC, or always be cost-cutting.
Uh-huh.
Come on, Jez.
I really don't think it's a good...
Oh, we've only got cheese and hummus. What is it? It doesn't look very much
like... It's turkey.
Like,
it's turkey leg.
Is that all right?
What can I tell you? I'm no Ainsley Harriet.
It looks weird. What's going on, Jeremy?
Nothing. It's just turkey. Look. See? Mmm. Undercooked, disgusting turkey. Hey, Mark, would you like some?
No, thanks.
Here, eat some turkey.
No, Jeremy, it's not my turkey.
I really feel since I'm eating turkey, you should eat some turkey. It was your idea to barbecue it.
I really don't feel like eating turkey, Jeremy. I'm full.
I'm eating dog leg. I have definitely reached a new low.
What's that on it?
Oh, there's hairs on it, Jeremy.
Hairs?
It's just a hairy turkey.
What's this? Mummy?
Mummy is probably the turkey's nickname. It could easily be.
They ate Mummy! They burned Mummy and killed her and ate her!
Look, I'll email through my references, Malcolm.
Rora, I'll call you.
Guess not fitting my CV onto one side of A4 is basically irrelevant now.
God, probably good things didn't work out with her. She is totally overreacting. It's not like I ate her mum or her dad.
Did you actually have to eat it?
I don't know. I keep wondering that. But, you know, in the moment, it really did feel like I needed to eat it.